Blackstone presents The Manifestations of Sherlock Holmes, a short story collection by James Lovegrove. This book is read by Dennis Kleinman. Introduction. There's a school of thought, let's call it My Dear Watson Elementary, that argues that Sir Arthur Conan Doyle wrote better Sherlock Holmes short stories than he did Sherlock Holmes novels. Or, to put it another way, a Sherlock Holmes adventure works most effectively at shorter length. To some extent, this theory is backed up by that crucial Holmesian prerequisite, hard evidence. Out of the four canonical novels, two, A Study in Scarlet and The Valley of Fear, are basically novellas augmented by subsidiary novellas that fill in the backstory of the case Holmes and Watson are investigating. Similarly, a third, The Sign of Four, hinges on a fairly lengthy piece of first-person exposition at the end. Only The Hound of the Baskervilles is what one might consider a proper single narrative novel, and even then it is punctuated by a middle section that takes the form of reports. Letters written to Holmes by Watson from Dartmoor and entries from Watson's diary, covering Holmes's apparent absence from the action. Whereas, by contrast, the 56 canonical short stories are quick, sharp hits of pure, unadulterated Holmes, with all the detection, analysis, and deduction that that entails. My own introduction to the world of Sherlock Holmes came via the short stories, specifically those in The Adventures of Sherlock Holmes, which my father read to me at bedtime when I was a boy from a slipcased illustrated edition that I still own and still treasure. And while I've published eight Holmes pastiche novels so far, I found it fascinating to tackle the character in the short story format as well. Sometimes I've used it as an opportunity to explore Holmes and his environment in ways that a novel will not necessarily support, to push the boundaries of what is considered a Sherlock Holmes tale, and to play a few, interesting to me and I hope also to others, variations on the central theme. Roughly half the stories in this collection, then, are standard traditional Holmes stories, adhering closely to the template established by Conan Doyle. They contain all the elements one might expect and do not deviate from the norm. There is nothing in them that would frighten the horses at King's Pyland stables. The remainder, however, veer off into less well-charted territory. They feature supernatural aspects, fantasy flourishes, a touch of horror, or else they focus on characters of Conan Doyle's creation who have been somewhat eclipsed by the great detective's extraordinary international celebrity. Through these 12 tales, I'm hoping to reveal different manifestations of Sherlock Holmes, other facets of his character, new approaches to a Holmes story, in order to show just how brilliant and versatile a fictional construct he is, as well as, of course, to entertain. James Lovegrove, Eastbourne, 2020. The Adventure of the Marchindale Stiletto. First published in the MX Book of New Sherlock Holmes Stories, Part 7, Eliminate the Impossible, 2017. Editor David Markham, MX Publishing. The brief for this particular anthology was that each story must present a seemingly supernatural mystery that, upon resolution, turns out to have a rational explanation. So how about a family curse, I thought. In this instance, however, no glowing spectral hound is involved, just an ancient dagger intimately bound to the history and continued prosperity of a wealthy dynasty. The MX Book of New Sherlock Holmes Stories, incidentally, is an ongoing series of top-quality anthologies, all compiled by the indefatigable Sherlockian David Markham, and all in aid of charity. Authors donate their contributions for free, and the proceeds from publication go towards the preservation of Undershaw, Conan Doyle's former home in Surrey, which has lately been renovated and transformed into a school for children with special needs. The Adventure of the Marchindale Stiletto.
Now here is a queer thing, said my friend Sherlock Holmes one September morning in 1883.
He passed the Times across the breakfast table to me and indicated a short article on the third page. Vanished Heirloom. Mystery surrounds the disappearance of the Marchindale Stiletto, the famed heirloom of the Marchindale family.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.